Disclaimer alert, disclaimer alert. Hey everybody, it's Dr. Jo. Today we're going to talk about neural glides or neural flossing. That is to get your nerves moving if you've had damage to them, if you've had surgery, maybe you have some scar tissue around them. So let's get into it. Probably wondering why I was making funny faces just a minute ago. You have three different nerves in your arm, the main nerves, which is your ulnar nerve, your median nerve, and your radial nerve. So with your ulnar nerve, to stretch that one out, you're going to put your pointer finger and your thumb together, making a A-OK sign, and you want to flip it up and come back down. Some people are only going to be able to get to about right here before they feel that stretch in the nerve on the outer part of their arm. So if you can only get to here, that's fine. You can do that. And just do that about 10 times. Then eventually you're going to go a little bit further, coming up and down. And hopefully you'll be able to get all the way up so you can make Birdman face. All right. The next one is your median nerve. That one's in the middle. You can put your arm straight out to the side and you want your palm to be up. You're going to keep your fingers as straight as you can and then move at your wrist and bring your fingers down. Now, some people just straight down is going to be enough stretch. If that's not enough stretch for you, then you can take your head to the opposite shoulder and go down and up. Same thing, just do about 10 of these at a time, because if you do too many, you can also irritate the nerve. Now, if you get 10 of these and you still don't feel a stretch, you can take it back a little, turn your head, and then stretch. Little pause at the end, come on back up. The last one, your radial nerve on top, because it's rad, you're going to put your arm out again, but now you're going to put your hand and palm down and repeat the same way, going down and up. And if that's not enough for you, then you can turn your head to the side, go down and up. And then if that's still not enough, go back just a little bit and go down and up. All right, the last one I'm going to show you is actually do some neural flossing or neural glides in your leg. A lot of people will do this for their sciatic nerve. So I'm going to hop up here and show you. So if you've been diagnosed with nerve damage in your leg, you're gonna wanna sit up in a chair or on your couch, just where you're comfortable. Now, stick out your leg and pull your toes towards you. Now, some people might feel a pull as soon as they pull their toes towards them. If you feel a pull with that, then you're just gonna point your toe, flex your toe back and forth, and that's moving that nerve up and down, is gliding it back and forth. If that's not enough, then you're going to slump your back down, pull your chin towards your chest, and then do the same thing, pulling your toes toward you, then pointing away from you. Simple as that. Make sure you just do about 10 to start off with, because you don't want to irritate those nerves. Those were the exercises for neural flossing or neural glides. Now remember, just start off with about 10 or so and then work your way up from there. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section. And if you'd like to check out some more videos, go to AskDoctorJo.com. And remember, be safe, have fun, and I hope you feel better soon.